Hey everybody, it's Mr. Eisens here, and we are getting into biomolecules. This is one of my favorite units. We just had talked about the digestive system, and now we got to talk about the molecules that we wind up eating every single day, okay? Biomolecules are going to be, the major ones are going to be things that we talk about and things that you see on the back of labels when you look at your food, all right? So no matter what you're eating, okay, let's see, I got a bag of chips right here. All right, these bag of chips, you go onto the back, and you can see all the different calories. Okay, the fats, the carbohydrates. Okay, the sugar would also be part of carbohydrates. And then lastly, this last one, you can't even see it, but protein. Okay, and so that's what we're talking about. We're talking about carbohydrates, which are sugars. We're talking about fats, which are fats, storage molecules, typically is what they wind up being in our bodies. And then we're going to talk about protein, okay, which is going to build, not only build muscle, but allow your cells to do everything, anything and everything that they do within your body. So let's get going. All these things are made up of atoms. That's actually the smallest unit, and you'll learn more about that in chemistry next year, especially when you do eighth grade chemistry. So, but these atoms are all made up of protons, electrons, and neutrons, okay? And we're not going to go too much in depth, but basically these simpler substances are called carbon, hydrogen, oxygen. Those are the ones that we're worried about, okay? CHO, okay? CHO is something that you want to remember. A group of atoms bonded together is called a molecule. So you got all these little tiny things, and now they come together, and now you have a molecule. So you have multiple of these atoms, okay? Two oxygens bonded together. That's oxygen that we breathe. Okay. Or we have C6H12O6, which is glucose, which we eat in all of our food. All right. Compounds, okay, are very similar to molecules because they are multiple, like they have different elements. Okay. But they're at the same ratio. So H2O, it has hydrogen and oxygen molecules. Okay. Elements bonded together. Okay. Two hydrogen atoms and one oxygen atom, okay? All these things are bonded together, and you have the same ratio over and over and over and over again. So there's always just a bunch of H2Os together at one time, all right? Nothing too crazy there. But biomolecules, bio means life. Molecules, we're talking about those elements and combinations of them. And so we're talking about what do we need to survive? What do all living things need or have inside their bodies? Well, let's talk about it. Okay. And here are the four things. Okay. Carbohydrates. All right. We're talking about sugars. Glucose is part of this. Monosaccharides. Mono meaning one, saccharides meaning sugar. Okay. So these are the things that you need to remember. You need to remember that, let's see if I can get my stylus out here. You need to remember, okay, here's a bunch of different food that we have. But I do want to go back. You need to remember that carbohydrates are paired with monosaccharides. There is one monosaccharide, and when there's multiple monosaccharides together, it makes up carbohydrates. Proteins is when we have more than one amino acid together. Okay. Lipids are made by fatty acids. Fatty acids are the monomer. Remember, mono means one. So one of a lipid is called a fatty acid. But when you have multiple, they're called lipids. Lipids are just fats, okay? Lipids are fats. So keep that in mind, okay? Nucleic acids, this is where we're talking about our DNA, all right? All living things have DNA, so we need nucleic acids as well. When we're talking about multiple, we're talking about nucleic acids. When we're talking about just a single one, we're talking about nucleotides, all right? And then lastly, we all need ATP as well, all right? If you want to check out this video, I suggest it. It will help. Okay. Let's move on. Oh, I got to get rid of this. This guy to there. Perfect. All right. Nice. And then let's erase everything. Wipe screen. There we go. All right. Thanks for being patient with me, guys. So let's talk about carbohydrates. We're talking about bread. We're talking about crackers. We're talking about we have carbohydrates in fruits and vegetables. Okay, we have it in anything that has sugar in it, has a bunch of carbohydrates. All right. But basically they're found in starches, sugars, and fiber. And that's just different versions of a carbohydrate. All right. But carbs is your preferred source of energy. And if you actually don't have these, your body starts, doesn't run as efficiently. I shouldn't say as efficiently. It just runs a little bit differently. Now they obviously, it makes up a lot of different foods and foods that you can eat pretty quickly, to give you energy. So they're nice. Chemical digestion of carbohydrates begins in your mouth. That's definitely going to be in your chest. Okay. Where the enzyme amylase, okay. Anything that ends with ace means to break down. Okay. So you have a big part and you're breaking it down into little pieces. Okay. We break down the carbohydrates into simple sugars, which would be monosaccharides, and glucose, which our body's actually going to wind up using. You can try this at home. You can put a cracker on your tongue without chewing, let the cracker sit there for a few minutes, and then you should taste a little bit of sweetness. It won't be too crazy, but you will taste a little bit of sweetness because you're breaking down the carbohydrates in the cracker to make monosaccharides. And once you have those simple sugars, they actually taste pretty sweet. Okay. So that's carbohydrates. They give you energy very quickly right now. Okay. That's why we want to include them in lunch and dinner and breakfast, because we want to have energy for our day. Okay. So let's continue on. Okay. Proteins. All right. Proteins are also very, very valuable because they build up a lot of things in our bodies, like our muscles. Okay. But they're made out of amino acids. There's actually only 23 amino acids. You'll learn that in high school. But because there's only 23 amino acids, you can think of it as the alphabet. You can make a million different words still, right? Millions of different words, because the alphabet only has 26. But the alphabet for proteins is only 23 letters long, so to speak. Okay, it's found in foods such as meat, eggs, dairy, nuts, and beans. Okay, protein, when you consume protein, they're broken down and then resynthesized. So you can think of them as you have a conglomerate of protein, you break them down, and now that you have all these little pieces, now you can build it back up to what you want it to be. Okay. So that's why they're very, very important to eat and part of a healthy diet. Okay. Whether you get them from, get a plant-based diet, or you get it from other animals in the form of meat. Okay. Chemical digestion of proteins begins in the stomach. Okay. With the gastric juices and acids, and then continues through the small intestine. All right. Whereas many enzymes are put onto the proteins and they're broken down further. All right. Lipids. All right. Lipids are fats, waxes, phospholipids, okay, like in the cell membrane, and then oils. So what we're talking about is all the, that's what lipids make up. And when we think about that when, on our food label, it's actually just going to be called fats. Okay. So they serve as a storage form of energy. Okay. So it's like taking a bunch of energy and now you're going to store it. And so that's why fats actually have a ton of energy in them. They're really high in calories. So you just got to be careful. You definitely need fat in order to survive, but you don't want to eat too much of it because it can stack up very, very quickly. Okay. So most of the chemical digestion of lipids occurs in the small intestines, from bile, from the liver, and the enzyme from the pancreas that breaks down lipids into small intestines. So bile created by the pancreas is going to break these down so that our body can actually use them. And they're used in a number of different things. Having fats really helps your hormones and keeps those levels healthy. Without fat, you can't make it. You need it. That's why it's one of the biomolecules. All right. So nucleic acids, we're talking about DNA now. That's why you see a picture of the DNA in the bottom right and in the bottom left. The bottom left is actually picture of DNA cut out of strawberries. Okay. So you mash up strawberries and then you give them a certain type of nuclease, which means it always breaks it down. Nuclease means you break stuff down. And so you're able to actually see all the DNA. We have so much DNA, it's just wrapped very efficiently and tightly, and that's why we can't really see it until you put a bunch of it together like you see in the bottom left, okay? So they make up the genetic materials, okay? The building blocks are called nucleotides, whereas the when there's multiple nucleotides together, it's called nucleic acid, all right? Chemical digestion of nucleic acids occur in the small intestines. Once again, the small intestines have all of the things being broken down in them, and then your body also absorbs, if you remember from the last video. Okay, the small intestines is where you absorb all of these biomolecules. All right. They're broken down by enzymes made in the pancreas. Digestion of nucleic acids and amino acids create ammonia. Okay, the ammonia is toxic and turned into urea in the liver. So where do we get our urea? Well, it's because we break down these, we eat a lot of things, plants and animals, once we're living or are currently living. Okay, and so they have DNA. And so we need to break those down, and then we need to get rid of the byproducts. And so that's where we get the ammonia and the bad, basically the bad smell from our sweat and our urine. Okay, adenosine triphosphate. Okay, we're talking about ATP. Okay, so let me just draw this out for you. But here's the adenosine. Here's the phosphate, phosphate, phosphate. There's three of them you can see, triphosphate. So the adenosine, you have a little sugar hooking the adenosine together with the triphosphate. And this is pretty unstable, okay? And so the thing is, this thing is bonded on very, very tightly. These P's are really, really, really close. And so as soon as you bump this molecule, you'll actually have this P shoot off. Okay, big explosion. Okay, NRG in the explosion. And then your body can use that energy to do things. Okay, to move molecules. Okay, and accomplish goals. All right. But let's talk about ATP in a single nucleotide. That is the form of usable chemical energy for living things. Okay, chemical formula. Well, that's everything that you would need for your adenosine triphosphate created in cellular respiration and lactic acid fermentation. Those are the two ways that we get ATP. Now you need, in order to get the ATP, you need glucose. Okay, because you take energy from that molecule and are able to put it into a new one, this ATP molecule, that then you can actually actively use. Whereas glucose stores that energy away. Okay. Let's see. This might be our last slide. I think it is. Okay. Basically, all in all, you're going to need all these things in order to survive and to maintain a healthy diet. Typically, you want about 40% carbs, 30% protein, and 30% fats for a balanced diet. And so you can kind of track that out, because every gram of protein, so a gram of protein is going to be equal to 4 calories. A gram of fat is going to be equal to 9 calories. And a gram of carbohydrates, okay, is going to be equal to 4 calories as well. So you can kind of plan out your diet that way. All right, guys. I'll see you later. Peace.